Honeypots can be deployed in a variety of locations on the network. A honeypot outside the external firewall is useful for checking attempts to scan or attack the internal network. The main advantages of placing the honeypot at this location are that, first of all, it does not have any side effect. Second, since it attracts and traps attacks to the honeypot, it reduces the amount of traffic, in particular the attack traffic, to the firewall. Therefore, it reduces the amount of alerts produced by the external firewall. On the other hand, honeypot at this location does not trap internal attackers. A honeypot can also be placed in a DMZ to trap attacks to the public-facing servers. On the other hand, a honeypot at this location may not be able to trap interesting attacks. This is because a DMZ is typically not fully accessible. That is, other than the well-defined public-facing services, no other services are supposed to be available in DMZ. That is, if an attacker is attempting to access the honeypot and a service is not one of these well-defined public-facing services, the firewall is going to block the traffic. What if you say, let the firewall allow such traffic to the honeypot? But this would mean that we are opening up the firewall, and this is a security risk. We can also place a honeypot in the internal network alongside with servers and workstations. The main advantages here are that it can catch internal attacks. It can also detect a misconfigured firewall that forwards impermissible traffic from the internet to the internal network. On the other hand, unless we can completely trap the attacker within the honeypot, the attack may be able to reach other internal systems from the honeypot. In addition, in order to continue to attract and trap the attackers to the honeypot, we must allow his attack traffic from the internet to the honeypot. This means that we must open up the firewall to allow the attack traffic to come from the internet to the internal network. And this carries a huge security risk.